Kansas. At forward, a 6'6 junior from Santa Ana, California, number 24, Alonzo Jameson. For North Carolina, at forward, a 6'7 senior from Nassau, the Bahamas, number 44, Rick Fox. For Kansas, at forward, a 6'7 senior from Oklahoma City, Oklahoma, number 32, Mike Maddox. For North Carolina, at a forward, a 6'7 sophomore from Roanoke, Virginia, number 34, George Lynch. For Kansas, at center, a 6'9 senior from Englewood, Colorado, number 42, Mark Randall. For North Carolina, at center, a 6'10 senior from Utah, Alabama, number 32, Pete Chilcutt. For Kansas, at guard, a 6'2 senior from Clyde, New York, number 3, Terry Brown. For North Carolina, at guard, a 6'4 junior from Burke, Virginia, number 40, Hubert Davis. For Kansas, at guard, a 5'11 sophomore from Reseda, California, number 30, Adonis Jordan. For North Carolina, at guard, a 6-foot senior from Binghamton, New York, number 21, King Rice. And the coaches for Kansas in his third season, Roy Williams. For North Carolina in his 30th season, Dean Smith.
Gentlemen, start your engines. We're in Indianapolis. And the race to the championship coming up next. Oh. In the blue uniform, starts out with Alonzo Jameson. In the corner to Maddox. He'll take the baseline on Lynch. Cross-court pass. The jumper well short by Adonis Jordan. Here comes North Carolina for the first time with King Rice. Over to Chilcutt.
Great man by both teams.
Fox takes the jumper. Way too strong. Jameson with the rebound.
Jameson doing a great job altering that shot. A very, very outstanding defensive player, as we know, on what he did to Todd Day in the second half of the Arkansas game.
Chilcutt had denied inside the entry pass, so they swing it back around. Maddox now back out to Jordan. He'll take the three-pointer. Yes!
Double team by Rice. Nobody picked up. He got stuck without a man.
Rice driving. King Rice. And the rebound by Chilcutt. Offensive rebound and bucket by Pete Chilcutt.
And Jim, if North Carolina does have an advantage, if the ball gets down in the low paint like that, I believe that's where they have the advantage on Kansas. Kansas on the advantage out on the perimeter.
Terry Brown with the awkward jumper off the rim and out of bounds. It belongs to North Carolina. So Adonis Jordan with a three-pointer for Kansas. Chilcutt with the basket for Carolina. Opening minute of play, this North Carolina team led by a nucleus of three seniors. King Rice, Rick Fox, and Pete Chilcutt.
Very important for King Rice to keep his dribble alive because of the overplays. Same thing for Jordan on the other end.
Fox gets it inside. Lynch makes the nice move in the basket.
And that's exactly what I'm talking about. More power on the paint.
On him. Stops the dribble, gets it over to Randall. Underneath to Alonzo Jameson.
How about that quickness with his footwork? Drop step inside.
Coming off 26 points and 9 rebounds in the regional final against Arkansas.
There we go. Picking up the dribble much too far away. That'll get you in trouble against a club like Kansas.
Jordan scoops it up, drives. Too strong. Fox on the rebound.
And
great opportunity.
Lynch.
Yes.
Lynch doesn't turn around.
Maddox makes the steal.
I don't know why George Lynch didn't keep his eye on the ball that time, because he was wide open.
Inside Randall, pump fakes, follow, scores.
Jim, again, a real key in this game for both Jordan and Rice, they have got to keep the dribble alive so that the cuts can be made. The minute they pick it up, everybody overplays and there's no passing lane.
Underneath to Lynch, missing the layup, the tip by Chilcutt. And picked up by Brown. Chilcutt with his second offensive rebound. Couldn't follow it this time. Maddox from the corner. And Chilcutt takes it away from his own teammate.
You know, I think that Chilcutt is totally exhausted, and that's that nervous energy that hits a player that gets up too high for the game. I would expect him to come out right away.
Rick Fox drives Jamison to the floor. Offensive foul on Rick Fox. And substitutions for North Carolina. Clifford Rozier comes in. Sean Tunstall, you're looking at for Kansas. And Billy, you're right, Chilcutt will sit. Eric Montross comes in, the freshman from right here in Indianapolis for the Tar Heels.
North Carolina does substitute early and often, but it's amazing how the emotional energy, there's the double team we talked about in the pregame show.
Two-pointer short. Maddox finds the loose ball and scores for Kansas. Now 9-4. Fox gets Jamison to commit. Back out to Rice for a three-pointer.
Good block out.
Underneath Ballo, score it. Hubert Davis.
Great block out by Jamison inside. Unfortunately for him, the ball went to the other side of the basket. See, bodies on everybody. Great job by Randall on the inside. Good block out everywhere around it, except the ball happens to go to the other side of the basket. Davis there for the pickup and the put away.
Looked like Clifford Rozier may have gotten away with one. His arms were locked with a Kansas player, and he took him out.
Jim, we're going to see a lot of bodies here. Kansas sets great, solid screens. They block out extremely well. You know you've been in the game physically when you play them.
All right, three-point opportunity for Davis. The foul went against Terry Brown. That pulls Carolina within two.
Mass substitutions as usual. There's the double team trap. Should be somebody alone under the basket. Too late.
Davis takes it away. Jam time for Carolina.
Brown was wide open.
Woodbury just into the game. Finds the open man, Randall. Back into a corner. Terry Brown, three-pointer. Missing for the second time. On the floor. Picked up by Carolina. Derek Phelps ahead to Fox. Skipped it over to Davis, who was hit, but no call.
Good defense by Brown. Right out on him.
Fox makes the save for the Heels. Davis will bring it back out.
Both teams are a little bit excited. They've got to get back in their offense. Dean Smith telling them to pull the ball back out a second. Montross, too big.
And yes, and a foul. Three freshmen on the floor for North Carolina, and Eric Montross comes home to Indianapolis and scores quickly.
Here is the advantage North Carolina has. Down on the blocks, they are about 2 inches taller per man. Montross, in addition to having the size in height, also has the great width to take up a lot of space inside. We'll see the pass cross court. Montross gets excellent position, holds his man off, and just keeps the ball above his head. Excellent play.
Now the 7-foot freshman.
Not a good free throw.
Missed the 3-point opportunity. A 7-0 run by North Carolina.
Richard Scott, who had that tough break yesterday in practice, severely looking like a severe sprain of the ankle out there, and he's running fairly well.
Henrik Rodel is in for the Heels.
Kansas has brought their offense up higher now, looking for some backdoor cuts.
Woodbury with Chilcutt all over. Tunstall with 15 on the shot clock.
Great defense by North Carolina on this occasion.
Adonis Jordan, three-pointer, in and out. Rodel with the rebound. Brings it up quickly. Freshman Phelps resets.
There was a pretty good back screen by Chilcutt.
Chilcutt gets the pass over to Fox. Turnaround shot is short. And it's off Kansas. 14-35 left in the first half. Carolina on a run and a 2-point lead. Carolina scores on the inbound play. His second basket.
Jim, if you notice any tendency so far, is that North Carolina really has a huge advantage down on the blocks with their size.
And the freshman Montross off to a terrific start.
You can't even see Scott when he gets in front of him down there. Scott's going to have to use his quickness.
Jamison drives, lost it, but off Carolina.
Jamison. Rice was the MVP of the Southeast Regional. Played statistically much better than he has all year long, but talking to people that saw a lot of Big 8 basketball, they felt all year long he was an outstanding performer.
Hunstall goes to the bench. Brown returns for the Jayhawks.
Switch on the out-of-bounds play.
Scott in the lane. Back to the rim. Montross just with the height advantage took it away. Pass up court. Reese swatted away. Score the basket. Brian Reese, a freshman from the Bronx, New York, scores in Carolina with 11 unanswered.
You can see now why the people of the state of Indiana hated to see Montross leave this state to go to college. He has been the difference so far early in the game. Good hit ahead to Reese, who has the ability to finish a play well. And the goaltend.
15-9, North Carolina. Lonzo Jameson.
Nice pass.
Right over to Maddox. Missed the short one. Chilcutt tipped it out, but they say he was on the back of Scott. So a foul against Carolina's Chilcutt.
Kind of a touch call there. Chilcutt was over Scott by about a foot and a half when he tapped that ball out to start what it would have been an easy break.
First on Chilcutt, second on the Tar Heels.
Now watch these out-of-bounds plays. North Carolina knows them as well as does Kansas. And when they run it, there's an awful lot of switching down inside.
Lynch in for Montross. And Randall returns for the Jayhawks. Scott will sit. Yeah, the inbounds plays already worked once for North Carolina. A moment ago, they got the easy basket inside with Montross. Now he needs some help.
Yep, not guarding the man taking the ball out of bounds.
Brown misses the jumper. Chilcutt with the rebound. Snaps it out to Rice. He's got a trailer with Davis. There he is. Couldn't find the handle.
Bad angle for that pass, Jim. You'd like to be able to pass that ball on a two-on-one fast break at a 45. Anytime you have to throw it straight across court, it's very difficult to catch.
Great angle here, Billy, to see what they're doing defensively.
Overplaying every pass. And so far, Jordan hasn't penetrated with the dribble.
Kansas has missed its last five shots.
Good weak side help.
Well, they had Lynch and Chilcutt down low on Randall. Kansas will inbound.
We talked about this being a game of execution, and so far, two things. North Carolina's size and their execution has been superior.
Oh, a near steal by Lynch. Would have been a breakaway layup and a jam, I'm sure, but a foul called instead.
Mike Maddox, talking to him yesterday. Of course, we know about his back problems. And somebody asked if he could make it. I believe it was Eddie Fogler, and he said, hey, there's just two more games to go. My back can get through two games. You can count on that.
Degenerative disc in his back, and then it's on to law school after this one, after this week. Randall from the baseline, well short. He hasn't gotten started yet. Fox out of bounds. Kansas keeps it. Well, you talk about all-time number of victories.
Well, they battled back and forth between Kentucky and North Carolina all year long, with Carolina finally taking the lead.
Wagner is in. Kirk Wagner for Kansas. A double team in the corner and a steal by North Carolina.
Well, what a bad place to put the ball, Jim. Down in the deep corner. Jameson had no chance there.
Richard Scott is back in for Kansas.
North Carolina setting their offense up much higher now. Looking for a back pick and a back cut.
Davis underneath. Pump fake.
Oh, he missed it.
How did that come out?
Everybody from North Carolina headed in the other direction. Well, that's the first backdoor play we've seen by either team.
Scott. That's nice. He gets the roll.
Left hand. Good play.
That breaks the dry spell for Kansas. They've gone 4.5 minutes without scoring. Chilcutt posting up. Over Wagner. Too strong. There's a strong rebound for you. Alonzo Jameson.
Nobody's stopping Jordan. He had a jump shot.
On the blocks, Wagner. Tip, no good. Jameson.
I believe it was Scott, Jim.
It is Scott. It's Richard Scott in and out of the game. And
that ankle injury, from yesterday. If you'd have seen him withering in pain, you never thought he'd be able to come out and play like that. Good D.
Jordan taking a piece of the arm of Rice, and he'll shoot two.
Well, he was right on Rice on that play. King Rice, the young man that went to the line for the pressure shots of his career against Temple and buried four as the game wound down in what was one of the real good ball games, I thought, of the regionals. Great show by Mark Macon of Temple, finishing up his career.
Probably, in fact, the best game of the regionals. King Rice now after going 9-for-9 in the East Regionals. He'll shoot two. You know what was really impressive about King Rice's performance in the two games at the Meadowlands? 13 assists, only one turnover. This for a young man who earlier in the season was greeted with a chorus of boos in a game against UConn. So King Rice delivers again. It's a four-point lead for North Carolina as we approach the midway point of the first half.
And Roderick.
Thomas Jordan in Kansas, trailing by four, 17-13.
Look at Montross out there playing defense. 30 feet away from the basket.
Jameson, nice move, missed it. But the tip in, again, it's Scott.
Second good offensive putback by Scott. Scott showing all's fair in love and war. He double teams as well.
Back cut, Fox scores for Carolina.
Well, back cuts to Carolina, none Kansas so far.
And the assist to Montross. Guarding on Scott now. And a foul against Richard Scott. His second, team foul number four.
And again, here is the evidence of the size differential. Montross just keeps his hands up. One thing you love to see a young big man do, and that is to keep his hands up above his shoulders. The John Wooden principle, you saw Bill Walton do it all his career. I'm not going to put Montross in that category yet, but a great fundamental principle that he has.
John Wooden is here at this Final Four.
Will be honored throughout the time by everybody in the state of Indiana for a great contribution to basketball.
Fox with the fadeaway basket and a foul.
An excellent entry pass. 45-degree angle. You're going to see that Fox gets Jameson on his hip. Jameson makes the move to try to get around over the top and can't get there in time. And comes down on the arm, and there's Rick Fox with the great strength that he has, putting it in for the shot.
That's the first on Jameson. Team foul number five, three-point play for Fox.
Of course, a reunion for Fox as well, who played high school basketball here in Indiana. There's the double team again. Wide open, not in time for Brown.
Traveling. Jordan made the move. Two of the heels committed, but Jordan traveled first. Jim Nance along with Billy Packer. Game one of the national semifinals from the Hoosier Dome.
Jim, what we're seeing so far, big height advantage, North Carolina paying off. Now for the first time, Kansas goes to their 1-3-1 half-court trap. Over the top of the trap.
And Montross misses it with the left hand. Off of Randall.
You cannot play that defense, 1-3-1, with Brown running the baseline. They'll throw right over the top of his head to Montross.
Come on, guys. Here we go.
Or in this case, to Lynch.
Henrik Rodel will inbound. Boy, Montross is playing big in this game so far. Three-pointer by Fox. Rodel on the follow. Tip try by Montross. Fox on the save. Wow, rattles it home. Seven again, for Rick Fox.
Again, Montross keeping the ball alive up on the board. Even though he didn't get the rebound, he kept it alive.
Underneath Randall. Mark Randall.
Great job by Randall down inside, putting his body on Montross so he couldn't get to him.
Four for Randall. Randall called for traveling. He wanted the foul call. Hunstall's back in for Kansas, and a couple of more subs about to enter. Patrick Ritchie and Richard Scott come back in.
Interesting that North Carolina has two fellas on the floor from the state of Indiana, Fox and Montross, but they have no one from the state of North Carolina on their squad, not a native.
Pete Chilton
guarding the ball out of bounds. Jim, I think Jordan's got to keep the ball in his dribble alive a little bit longer to get something started. He's picking it up awful early.
Richie's pass denied inside. Great D by Chilka. Ahead to Rodel. Skips it over. Fox is open for the three-pointer. And over the back is Chilka.
Good block out by Scott, but he's getting a little tired right now. I would imagine we'll see him coming out taking a break.
Two on Chilcutt, four on the Tar Heels.
The one difference I have seen in regard to North Carolina and Kansas, I haven't seen anybody from Kansas hold up the fist yet, asking to come out. Obviously a long-time tradition for North Carolina. I guess nobody wants to come out of a Final Four game.
Richie takes the baseline. And they say Grant was grabbed by Phelps. Derek Phelps called for the infraction. His first and team foul number five. Tennessee advanced today, Billy.
Advanced against Virginia, the team that kept them, Pat Ed Summit, from being able to go to the Final Four last year. And that now they get a chance to meet them for the big game.
Brian Reese is in for Coach Dean Smith. Fox will get a rest.
Sean Tunstall not able to get off the mark. He and Brown have been very hot in this tournament, and they can't get anything going.
Scott inside, having a nice game eight for Richard. Scotty, again, twisted an ankle in practice yesterday, but he looks strong. From off the floor, Rodel lobs it inside, too high for Montross.
Chilcutt runs Scott down. No advantage, no foul.
Freshman Patrick Ritchie handling the ball, getting it back outside to Scott.
Ooh, what a screen by Randall.
From the floor, he loses it. Does Jordan. Phelps will bring it back out. Now on a wing, it's Reese. Good shot by the freshman.
Everybody wondered when this great freshman recruiting class was going to pay off for Dean Smith. Need they ask more? You notice how North Carolina forces baseline. They've done this for years, and then they get the weak side help. Richie into the traffic.
Into Scott. And a foul called on Montross.
Big half for Scott. And how about the recruiting class Roy Williams put together? You know, you didn't get all the notoriety, but he couldn't have off-campus visits.
That's what's so surprising.
It's incredible to see him do so well. He's got the good basis for a club for years to come.
Not allowed to have an on-campus paid-for visit by a recruit until January of 90, just 15 months ago.
Correct. This young man certainly showing an awful lot. Dean Smith over there trying to work the officials, saying Scott's doing a lot of leaning in.
8 points, four rebounds, three of them on the offensive end. Freshman from Little Rock, Arkansas, shooting two. Matter of fact, he said, I can go home and have bragging rights after Kansas eliminated Arkansas in the Southeast Regional Final. First Arkansas player to play at Kansas in 20 years. Timeout on the court, 7:42 left in the first half. And North Carolina with a six-point lead. Court scoring goes to Carolina. Fox leading the way with seven.
To amplify on that backcourt scoring, the three backcourt performers, Jordan and Tunstall and Brown, 1 for 8 so far. Bad catch by Chilcutt.
Somehow Davis saves it and squirts it over to Rice. Now Lynch finds Fox roaming on the baseline. Didn't know what to do with it under the cylinder. And Chilcutt missed the follower, the easy one.
Second time today, Davis before Chilcutt on that occasion, missing about an 8-inch shot.
Jamison in traffic. Foul called on Rick Fox. Let's get a report now from Leslie Visser.
Jim, in the last timeout, an emotional Roy Williams told his team he wants quite a tall order. He wants them to help on the big man. He said they're being much too timid. He wants them to be certainly more aggressive, not allow so many second opportunities, and to keep moving. Jim?
Well, for that man, it's his 100th game as the head coach at Kansas. He's won 75 of his first 99. Foul on Fox, and Randall will shoot two.
Of course, that great 30-5 season with the club was picked preseason fifth in the Big Eight.
You know, Billy, in the history of college basketball, only one coach has won more games his first three seasons, and that was Everett Case, who won 80 at NC State.
You know, another crazy one about coaching, the only coach with a losing record in Kansas history, the man who invented the game of basketball, Dr. Naismith.
Lynch.
Chilcutt. Chilcutt had an opportunity to catch that and put it back up. He was in great position, didn't take advantage of it. Kansas starting to regain some composure now. They're just not giving Brown any opportunity to shoot that three-point shot.
Brown's the leading scorer for the Jayhawks, 16 a game, and a turnover. At the conclusion of both of today's games, we'll be selecting Chevrolet Players of the Game. In conjunction with the award, Chevrolet donates $1,000 to the General Scholarship Fund of each school.
You see Jordan picking up much higher now, actually over on the other side of half court. Be a good time for a solid screen.
Boy, Jamison had that one read, got his feet tangled. Chilcutt takes the open shot from the baseline.
Tough break for Kansas, and Jamison hurt himself a little bit on that play. I thought he was tripped.
Dumps it into Maddox, high off the glass.
Maddox just out-positioned Chilcutt on that play. See how high Jordan is picking King Rice up now? A solid screen would work on Jordan.
Lobbing it high, Chilcutt underneath. And Jamison brings it down and sets it out for Kansas. Now Jordan will take the long three shot. Lynch on the rebound, Carolina coming right back.
It would have worked to perfection. Lynch just didn't hold it up. Fox faked out his own teammate.
Seven turnovers for North Carolina. Perimeter shooting. How about that for Kansas? 1 of 12 as we see Montross back in the game.
And the fans sitting in this arena who are big IU fans wondering, where were those shots against Bob Knight's team?
That's a game where Kansas just blew them out in the first half. Jamison, good move with men on him. Was patient on the blocks. Three-point game, 29-26 Tar Heels. Rice stopped his dribble, put up a bad shot, and a foul called on King Rice.
Well, if Roy Williams was asking for his teams to get a little more physical, Jordan showed him exactly what he meant there, the smallest guy on the floor for Kansas, but the toughest down in low.
First on King Rice and the eighth on North Carolina. So a 1-1 for the Jayhawks.
And Jim, on that last drive by Rice, a clear out, which Carolina uses particularly when they want to go down the wire as the shot clock is ticking down or the game is, Kansas had scouted very well because they let Rice drive to the inside and then commit. And everybody played their own man and he was forced to take a bad shot.
Adonis Jordan with a 1-1. Could pull Kansas within one. You know, 2 years ago, Adonis asked his mother, how did you come across that name? And she told him about Greek mythology and how the figure was a figure of beauty in Greek mythology. And now he likes to go around and tell some people about his unique first name. Adonis missing the second one, but gets the rebound.
See Kansas settling down. You get a feeling they're back into their game a little here.
And Maddox ties it. A 7-0 run by Kansas.
Roy Williams going wild on the sidelines. He wants his team down in defensive position, just as if he's guarding Hubert Davis himself.
Davis with nowhere to go. Rice cuts to the basket.
All hands. Nice play.
King Rice with the save. Lynch underneath. Step on the line, Kansas basketball.
Kansas has picked it up a notch on both ends of the floor. Got their composure on the offensive end and picked up the defensive intensity. And North Carolina has not been able to get in a situation where they're getting the ball down and low, where they controlled the blocks early on in the game. step out to deny the ball on the wings. North Carolina goes zone. Now look for Brown. He's got to find a spot up so he can get off the three. Here he is.
Well, he takes the three-pointer. You call that one. Three for Terry Brown, his first points of the game.
And that's why Carolina is not going to play a lot of zone today.
Lynch off balance will go to the line for two. Foul on Randall, his first. Six on Kansas.
I want to point out something about Roy Williams, and for that matter, Eddie Fogler, too. Two of the young coaches that grew up in Dean Smith's system. One of the reasons I think he has made the adjustment from assistant to head coach so well is the fact that for so many years, they were the JV coaches. And you got an opportunity to sit on that bench, call the shots, not just be an assistant coach that goes out and scouts and recruits. And here you can see on Dean Smith's side, of course, the great Phil Ford, one of his outstanding players from the past.
Lynch makes one of two. Kansas leading 32-30. Slashing. Coming up short, Randall for Kansas.
Tremendous defensive balance by Kansas getting back. The transition from offense to defense on their part has been excellent.
Now Dean Smith off the bench. Followed by Maddox. Missed the open tip, but here comes Randall to score. Maddox had the open opportunity, much like Chilcutt did before for Carolina.
We've seen a lot of putbacks that have not been put back under control.
Foul called on Kansas on Brown, his second, and that'll send North Carolina to the line for a 1-1.
Jim, it's interesting to watch the flow between these two teams. North Carolina had their good run because they settled down on the half court, started to run their offense and take advantage of their size. All of a sudden, they're getting helter-skelter, a lot of that due to Kansas's up-tempo defense. And now we see Kansas on the other end of the floor getting into their offense much better with a low post. Good floor balance.
As Brian Reese gets set to shoot a 1-1. More substitutions a moment ago. On the floor for Carolina, Chilcutt, Montross, Rodel, Phelps, and Reese. Missing the free throw. Randall to Tunstall. Joined on the floor by Scott, Jamison, and Brown. Before the shot, they say a push.
Going to be on Chilcutt. So far, Pete Chilcutt, the senior, and Dean Smith gets a technical. A technical on Dean Smith, but I don't agree with Coach Smith. I think that what's happening is Pete Chilcutt is getting beat inside. Scott, Jamison, Randall are all beating him. He's been out of position inside.
So Chilcutt, Billy, slapped with his third personal.
Let's look down inside. Pete Chilcutt's behind. He just didn't do the job here. He got beat out by position. And I would certainly agree with the official. He was right on top of the call.
1-1 is first.
Scott having a great first half.
Now Adonis Jordan will shoot the technicals.
We talked about that stat. Kansas coming into the tournament as the 64th best free throw shooting team in the tournament. What's interesting, they play good free throw defense, Jim. Opponents only shoot 65% against them. You know, that must be contagious. Kind of like Syracuse in the Big East for so many years.
How about the years when Kansas has had good shoot free throw shooting teams?
Isn't that crazy? When their best free throw shooting teams are the two teams that have the poorest records.
That's a break for Carolina. They make one free throw out of the bunch. It could have been four had they converted the 1-1 into technicals. We'll be right back.
Carolina is taller and stronger, has been getting a lot of productivity on the inside. Let's go back to Jim.
All right, James, a timeout called by Jamison at the last moment as they cannot find anyone open on the inbounds pass. Team with the Midwest Dome experience is Duke having come out of the Metrodome and the Silver Dome to get to the Hoosier Dome. We'll see Duke and UNLV in our second national semifinal. There it is, 16-3, the last 7 minutes.
And Jim, let's see if Kansas doesn't go for a strike trying to score on this out-of-bounds play. I thought they might go long and try to strike because North Carolina was overplaying so much.